You see this pen? Do you see this pen, Erica?
I do.
Sell me this pen. Come on, Twinkie. Nah, I'm just kidding. Listen, this is my deal inking pen. It's my Our Home deal inking pen. But I'm gonna be real with you guys. I haven't used a pen in a long time. See, we've got technology. In fact, right now, we're working on building out a system for our new virtual assistant. Chris started with us earlier this year, and we've got him so overwhelmed that it's like, hey man, look, I can't manage 25, 30 files if I don't have some help. And so he's like, well, you either need to pay me $300,000 a year or get you a VA. So I got him a VA. At our last team meeting, Eric and myself went and pulled back everyone's activity report in the last, 45 days. And it's not a situation of where we're trying to be mean, but when agents come on to work with Our Home Real Estate, we set a certain level of expectations of what we expect and what they expect. And when somebody walks into my office and they say, hey, I've got a $100,000 goal that I want to accomplish, well, here's the deal. We're going to give you a $100,000 a year activity that you have to make. You know, there's a small percentage of people in the entire world that will make that much income in a single year. And the cool thing is we'll have several of our agents make that this year. In fact, no one on my team should make less than that if they're doing the activities, if they desire that. Our goals don't necessarily meet everyone else's goals. So, you know, we just got to put all the pieces of the puzzle to make sure that we're growing. Part of that is having great camaraderie though. We really truly operate as a team. I was gone last week at a real estate conference, came back this weekend. I want to do something fun with the agents. We're going to do a cookout, but main event opened back up. We all love to bowl. So went out and bowled, had some drinks, food, everything, and kicked it. That's important because you get to let work go, right? And real estate's stressful. It's high stress. You know, nowadays everybody wants everything right now. So we got to kick it. We had fun. You know, I'm pretty sure that my wife and Chevy's wife beat us, which is kind of embarrassing. But, you know, we're more focused on shooting the breeze and drinking some cold beers. That's the excuse, Chevy. All right. Stick together. But anyways, and then after the fact, some of us stayed late and did arcades and had a blast. And one of our wife's husband, he's a plumber and he's done a lot of work for us. So me and him, you know, shooting hoops and cutting up. It's just good, man. It's good to let go and cut up and have fun because at the end of the day, we're still people too. We're putting together a system so that anything that's been duplicated multiple times and repetitive that we are trying to automate as much as possible. We put together a list of things that need to change. This is probably more that I've written down in 3 weeks because I hate writing. So we've got like 25, 30 pendings right now, which is awesome. You know, it's good problems to have. We went through COVID-19, it sucked. And so it's just been a busy time out of it. Our team's grown triple in size in the last 6 months. And we've been able to do well over 100, 150 transactions with the core, pretty much the core four agents. And so now we've got some studs and some studettes. Don't want to get labeled as sexist, right? I've got women on my team. In fact, I've got more women on my team than guys. So don't label me. If you are watching this, don't label me. We've got some really good up and coming hitters that are going to come out and really produce. And we're excited about that. But as you scale, you know, I've always been in production mode, go, you know, grind out. And it's really, I mean, our agents have had an unfair advantage because they get to go and see someone that's been through hundreds of real estate transactions every single day. What that's done is it's putting a lid on our agents. And I want to be able to give our agents every resource that we can to make sure that they have all of the tools to do it. Not only be able to have the training on how to make the phone calls and what to do, but also the system, right? The game plan, the execution plan. But with that, you have to be able to track your metrics. You know, Tony Robbins says that all the time, where your mind goes, energy flows. And so like if your head's in Destin at the beach every day of your life, you're probably gonna have zero production. But if your mind is always being stimulated on, hey, this is where you're at, this is where your mark's at, you're 82% of the way there. What are you gonna do when you're at 82%? You're gonna go and get 95%. And when you're at 95%, you're like, man, I'm already at the home stretch. I'm gonna get the rest of it. And so I'm stepping out of that position that I'm so most comfortable in to step up to where I'm working on the business, not in the business. It's uncomfortable for me. And so, you know, I'm putting together all the places. I've spent countless hours building out training programs for our agents. But now, because I can teach anyone how to sell, but I'm not good at babysitting. I'm not a good babysitter. I don't have kids. If you want me to babysit for you, I'm gonna charge you 15% commission, just gonna tell you now. You know, I'm not good at that. And so now we're building out systems to where we can have automation to where these agents are getting updates. Hey, look, you're at 53% goal. You're at 78% goal. This is what you need to do. And so at the end of the day, like, we give you all the resources in the world, but if you don't go out and make sure that you're maximized on it, then whose fault is it? You can lead a horse to the water, but you can't make him drink.